Oh, I better turn down the volume and get ready to pump you up to learn some phrasal verbs. Hi, welcome to Jen's Jugyo. My name is Jen, and today I'm going to teach you 12 phrasal verbs connected to music. A phrasal verb is a verb, an action word, plus a preposition. Words like in, on, at, from, to are prepositions. And the verb and the preposition come together to create a new, unique, non-literal meaning in English. For example, our first music phrasal verb for today is be into. Be is the verb, MR is, was or were, and into is the preposition. To be into something means that you really like it, you really, really enjoy that thing. When we're talking about music, most people are into certain genres of music. For example, I am into Broadway show tunes. I'm also really into jazz music. However, my husband is really into pop music. These days, many people are into K-pop music. Our second music phrasal verb for today is take up. Take up means to start a new hobby or to start playing a new instrument regularly. You're doing it for the first time and developing a habit of doing this activity. For example, when I was in junior high school, I decided to take up the saxophone. During the pandemic, I thought I would take up playing the keyboard, but I didn't get very far with my keyboard skills. Phrasal verb number three is tune up. If you tune up a musical instrument, it means that you are adjusting the instrument to the correct pitch. So you're tuning the instrument to make sure that it doesn't sound too sharp or too flat. You need to tune it up. When I was in high school, I was in a jazz band, and before any of our rehearsals or any of our concerts, we would always spend 5 minutes tuning up our instruments as a band. When I go to the symphony, I love hearing the instruments tune up before the concert begins. Phrasal verb number four is join in. Join in means to participate in an activity, to do an activity that other people are already doing. For example, at a concert, the audience might join in with the main singer when it comes time to sing the chorus. I love this part of the song where the saxophones join in the trumpets to create the melody. For phrasal verb number five, I have two phrasal verbs together because they are opposites. The phrasal verbs are to turn up the volume and to turn down the volume. If you turn it up, it means that you are increasing the volume and making it louder. If you turn it down, it means that you are decreasing the volume and making it quieter. So at a party, if you're playing music really loudly and it's nighttime, your neighbors might knock on the door and say, "Could you please turn down the music?" Or if your friend really likes a certain song, they might say, "Oh, I love this song, turn it up." Phrasal verb number six is belt out. To belt out something means to sing it very, very loudly. Up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stay all day in the sun. That is my favorite song to belt out when I'm in the shower. It's always fun to belt out your favorite songs at karaoke with friends. Phrasal verb number seven is put on. Put on means to organize some kind of event or concert. I get really excited whenever I hear that one of my favorite Canadian bands is putting on a show. The first concert I ever went to was put on by the Moffats. Phrasal verb number eight is cap off. To cap something off means to finish a certain event with a really good, fun activity. For example, if you go to a concert, at the end of the concert, the band might cap off their set by playing their most popular song. During her vacation, after a lot of sightseeing, she decided to cap off her day by going to a jazz concert in a cafe. Phrasal verb number 9 is blow away. We use this as an adjective to be blown away by someone or something. What this means is that something leaves a very positive impression on you. You feel very excited and positive about this thing or person. For example, the first time I ever heard Joe Hisaishi's music, I was blown away by his amazing composing skills. He's my favorite composer. Every time I hear Ella Fitzgerald sing, I'm blown away by how amazing her voice is. Phrasal verb number 10, I again have two phrasal verbs for you that have opposite meanings. When you listen to music, there are two main things that might happen to you. You might be able to chill out by listening to the music, or you might be able to get pumped up by listening to the music. So to chill out means to become calm and to feel relaxed. The opposite is pumped up, to get lots of energy and feel really, really excited, pumped up. So if I listen to classical music, I can chill out. If I listen to rock music, I feel pumped up. Rock music will pump you up, and classical music will help you to chill out. Phrasal verb number 11 is to come across. Come across. If you come across something, it means that you discover it unexpectedly. For example, the other day when I was doing some cleaning, I came across this old Backstreet Boys CD. Recently, while I was listening to different music on YouTube, I came across a new artist called Masayoshi Takanaka. I was very surprised to listen to some of his music. Phrasal verb number 12 is break up. Breakup means for a band to separate. For example, in 1970, the Beatles broke up due to musical differences. In the early 2000s, many bands that were popular when I were a kid broke up. The Spice Girls broke up in the early 2000s. NSYNC and the Backstreet Boys also broke up in the early 2000s. Did you know the phrasal verb break up has other meanings as well? If you'd like to learn the other meanings and learn some other excellent break phrasal verbs, please check out a video I've made about that over here. So today, you have learned more than 12 phrasal verbs connected to music that you can use to sound more like a native English speaker. And now it's time for question of the day. I have two questions for you. The first question is, what genre of music are you into? And the second question is, who is a musician or band or composer that you are blown away by? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching this lesson. If you found it useful, please subscribe to Jen Studio and give this video a thumbs up. Good luck with your English studies, and I'll see you in the next lesson.